So the first numerical is, if n is positive integer, then prove that 1 plus I whole raised to n plus 1 minus I whole raised to n is equal to 2 into 2 raised to n by 2 cos n pi by 4. Hence deduce that 1 plus I raised to 10 plus 1 minus I raised to 10 equal to 0. Now friends, for deduction, we will first prove the result. And to prove the result, we will start from left hand side. As you can see, on left hand side, two complex numbers are given, 1 plus I and 1 minus I, and power is asked, that is raised to n, in both the complex numbers. On right hand side, 2 raised to n by 2 cos n pi by 4, it means trigonometric term is given. Now you all know that any complex number has three types of form, that is Cartesian, exponential and polar. Now here, what you can see is Cartesian form of a complex number, and on right hand side cos term is asked. Now if you want to find out power of a complex number, then there is one theorem which I taught you, which is nothing but de Moivre's theorem. So using de Moivre's theorem, we can find out the power of a complex number. But let me tell you my friends, de Moivre's theorem is applicable on polar form only. So if you want to find out power of a complex number, then you need to convert a given complex number in polar form. So here our first duty will be to convert given numbers in polar form. So let's assume the first number as z, which is 1 plus I. So we have seen in the previous topics that how to convert the given Cartesian form of a complex number in polar form. So to convert in polar form, we require r and theta, that is modulus and amplitude of complex number. So here we will first find out r. So comparing the given number with x plus iy, so we get x equal to 1, y equal to 1. So therefore, r is nothing but mod z, that is modulus, is root of x square plus y square, which is root of x is 1, y is 1, 1 square plus 1 square, which is equal to root of 2. So this is modulus. Now we will find argument. Argument is nothing but theta, which is equal to tan inverse of y by x, which is equal to tan inverse of 1 upon 1, that is 1. And you all know that tan inverse of 1 is pi by 4. So theta is pi by 4. So here 1 plus I, which is Cartesian form, is equivalent to a polar form where r is root 2 and theta is pi by 4. So pi by 4 plus I sine pi by 4. Similarly, I will convert this second number in polar form. So 1 minus I. So for this, I will find out. So it is z1 and z2. So for this second number, I will find out r, which is again root of 1 square plus minus 1 square, because here you can see x is 1 but y is minus 1. So again r becomes root 2. And next we'll find theta for this. So this was theta 1, now we'll find theta 2. So it will be tan inverse y by x. Now here y is minus 1, x is 1. So we will get tan inverse of minus 1, which is nothing but minus tan inverse of 1, which is equal to minus pi by 4. Now be careful my friends. Here the number is given as 1 minus I. Here x part is positive, y part is negative. It means this number will lie in fourth quadrant. As you all know that in the fourth quadrant, y is negative and x is positive. So, in the last session, I've told you some of the formulas to find out argument. And according to that formula, if your complex number lies in the first or fourth quadrant, then whatever is the value of theta, it is your final answer. It means here, argument is equal to minus pi by 4. So I will use it and I will convert 1 minus I in polar form. So it will become root 2, because root 2 is modulus and theta is minus pi by 4. So it will become cos of minus pi by 4 plus I sine minus pi by 4. Now we all know cos of minus theta is cos theta. So it will become cos pi by 4, and sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So it will become plus will become minus I sine pi by 4. So this is value of 1 minus I. Now we have converted both complex numbers in polar form. Now we need to find out power n of both the complex numbers. So for that reason we will take power of polar form of a complex number. So it will give us now 1 plus I raised to n equal to. So according to de Moivre's theorem, it will become root 2 inside bracket cos pi by 4 plus I sine pi by 4 whole raised to n. So by de Moivre's theorem, it will give us root 2 raised to n, and here this power will multiply the amplitude. So we will get cos n pi by 4 plus I sine n pi by 4. Similarly, if I will try to find out nth power of this second complex number, then by de Moivre's it will become root 2 raised to n cos n pi by 4 minus I sine n pi by 4. Now, we have been asked this result, that is addition of this complex number should be equal to 2 into 2 raised to n by 2 cos n pi by 4. So for that, on LHS, I will add both the results. So I will say LHS equal to 1 plus I raised to n plus 1 minus I raised to n. So it will give us, so it means I need to add, this is result number 1 and result number 2. So if I am adding these two results, then I will add these two results. So when we will add these two results, that time we can take root 2 raised to n as common. So root 2 raised to n common, and we will add these two terms with these two terms. So when we add, this plus I sine and minus I sine will get cancelled out, and we will get 2 times cos n pi by 4. Now we all know that square root of 2 is nothing but 2 raised to 1 by 2 whole raised to n into 2 cos n pi by 4. So it will give us 2 as it is. 2 raised to 1 by 2 raised to n. Here powers will multiply each other. So 1 by 2 into n, it will be n by 2. So 2 raised to n by 2 into cos n pi by 4, which is nothing but your right hand side. So it means we have proved the result. Now how to find answer of deduction? Now what was the deduction? Let's see. Now this was the deduction. You need to deduce 1 plus I raised to 10 plus 1 minus I raised to 10 equal to 0. It means here value of n is 10. So what I'll do, whatever result that we have proved, I will just substitute n equal to 10 in the result and we will get our answer. So we will put n equal to 10 in the result. So we have result 1 plus I raised to n, that is 1 plus I raised to 10, 1 minus I raised to n, which will become 1 minus I raised to 10 is equal to, this was the right hand side. So we will get 2 into 2 raised to 10 by 2 cos of 10 pi by 4. Now 10 by 2 is 5. 2 raised to 5 into 2 is 2 raised to 6. And cos, here we will get 2 2's are 2 5's are. So we will get cos 5 pi by 2. So my friends, if you will check cos 5 pi by 2 in your calculator, you will get cos 5 pi by 2 is 0. So it means 0 into 2 raised to 6 is 0. So therefore, we have proved the result that is being asked. So we have deduced it by substituting n equal to 10. That's it. Now, this was the deduction. You need to deduce 1 plus I raised to 10 plus 1 minus I raised to 10 equal to 0. It means here value of n is 10. So what I'll do, whatever result that we have proved, I will just substitute n equal to 10 in the result and we will get our answer. So we will put n equal to 10 in the result. So we have result 1 plus I raised to n, that is 1 plus I raised to 10, 1 minus I raised to n, which will become 1 minus I raised to 10, is equal to, this was the right hand side. So we will get 2 into 2 raised to 10 by 2 cos of 10 pi by 4. Now 10 by 2 is 5, 2 raised to 5 into 2 is 2 raised to 6, and cos, here we will get 2 2's are 2 5's are, so we will get cos 5 pi by 2. So my friends, if you will check cos 5 pi by 2 in your calculator, you will get cos 5 pi by 2 is 0. So it means 0 into 2 raised to 6 is 0. So therefore, we have proved the result that is being asked. So we have deduced it by substituting n equal to 10. That's it.